welcome. So this is the third innovation talk of today. The particularity of these talks of this afternoon is that up to now we've been talking product systems. Now we're going to be talking about you, us as consumer. And you will see that we will deal with how to act on our behaviors in order to make a more sustainable world and to reduce our energy consumption. So, myself, I'm François Courtier, I'm in charge of marketing for residential building in Europe, and I'm thrilled and very honored to have Jack Ham, who is an associate professor in the Eindhoven University. So, welcome, Jack. And Jack has been working on many studies looking at the behaviors of consumers, and especially on the stimulus that potentially it can impact the behavior that we have, especially when it comes to energy consumption. But before, welcome, Jack.
Thank you.
And before we dig into the studies that you've been leading in recently, we know that Schneider has recently performed a study and on the panel of consumers all over the world, mainly Europe, Australia and USA. And we would like to have your comment and on this topic and the main outcomes from this study.
Now, yeah, indeed a very interesting and extensive report and an extensive study with so many people in there. And it mainly showed that people indeed do understand how important sustainability is, and that they and this surprised me, that they really understand also that they themselves are responsible for many of these issues that we now struggle with as a society. So people understand that it's their own behavior that has to change. And well, that's the core of it. There's also a lot of differences between countries that reports addresses, and now some willingness of people to start buying certain devices is investigated. But especially this understanding, this awareness of people that they need to change their behavior, and a related motivation to do so. This is a very important finding.
Excellent. So now you've performed a lot of studies and inquiries about the consumer. So can you tell us a little bit more about how do you identify the stimulus impacting the behaviors we may have in order to save energy and to work on energy consumption, which I think was one of the biggest points of the study?
Now, indeed, we know that people care about sustainability and that people want to change their behavior. Very often people...
Closer.
Indeed. Getting close to people is crucial, is really, really important. And what we see here, where we are now, is a home built by Schneider to show the products that they deliver for people living in this home. However, the people aren't really there. Well, we have lots of visitors, but the inhabitants can't be seen. And those are the people who have to change their behavior. And those people might be aware. They are aware that they need to change their behavior. Oh, there we go. And they are aware that they need to change their behavior. And Schneider technology and other forms of feedback systems may make people aware of the actual amounts of energy that they are consuming, that they're using when programming the washing machine or the dishwasher. And in studies, we have presented people with these kind of numbers. For example, in this interface, actually, it's a Miele interface on the washing machine that shows you how much energy you are using when you program the washing machine in a certain way, presenting people with factual feedback, as we might call it, and that helps them save energy. Indeed, without such an energy bar, people don't have a clue. People don't have any idea what amount of energy they might be consuming. However, these numbers are difficult to people, our research shows. We present the people with an energy bar and with other kinds of numbers and little graphs, indicators in percentages, kilowatt hours, euros. And actually, it didn't matter too much which of those variables we presented to participants. All of them led to an equal decrease or increase in energy consumption, especially a decrease, of course, when we told them how much they were using. And we thought after a while, perhaps it is more like the evaluation that we hand over to people, it's a low or high amount of energy consumption that they do understand, and not the precise number. So awareness, indeed, is a special thing in the psychology of consumers. People are aware of many things, but we also know that a lot of people's behavior is driven more by unconscious mental processes. So there's also other sensitivities that people have, like, for example, sensitivities to social evaluation. We know that people do a lot of things that they do because they want to be evaluated in a positive way by other people. We buy expensive clothes with a nice brand label on it because we want to be evaluated in a certain way by other people. And research shows that also when these other things that evaluate us are not necessarily people, but rather artificial social agents, like this robot here, that's evaluating this guy's energy consumption behavior while he's programming. That's also a washing machine interface. When such an artificial social agent evaluates your behavior, you also change your behavior. And indeed, our studies show that social evaluation, somebody else evaluating you, is much more powerful for changing people's behavior than simple facts, because those facts don't really fit to your sensitivities. So these social forms of feedback seem to lead to a twice as large a decrease of energy consumption as compared to presenting people with numbers. So our little robot here seems to be quite an effective helper. And it may not necessarily have to be a robot. There's also all kinds of other social entities, like these artificial agents on screen that you might use, that you might incorporate into a television screen in your home, for example. And already here in the Snyder home, we have such an image, at least, of a lady on a computer screen that may evaluate your energy consumption behavior.
Do you see on any other further way that could influence our behaviors?
Yeah, so you might use those artificial social agents in many different contexts. And since we're building electronics here, smart home electronics, we might build devices that are incorporated into people's homes, like this lady here that evaluates your warm water consumption when washing your hands at the sink, and she starts frowning when you use more warm water. But there's even weirder ways of trying to influence people. You might, for example, fit the influencing strategy that you use to the particular characteristics of a person. So we know that especially people who are a bit lonely are influenced more strongly by other people because they want to reconnect to them. So you might, especially for certain people, at certain moments in time, when it's Christmas time, for example, and you're at home alone, use these social influencing strategies. Or we might make computer systems look a bit like you, like this artificial agent on the right-hand side. That looks like the actual user. We know that people are more sensitive to influencing strategies that come from other people who are a bit like them, like when your children try to influence you. And you might go a lot further. You might, for example, sorry, that was just another example. You might use other kinds of technology too, like virtual environments to influence people's behavior. Allow people to experience what it is like if we keep on consuming energy like we do. Especially when you live in the Netherlands, an image like this, well, an environment like this is totally relevant, living behind dikes. And we know that people's environments pose a huge influence on their behavior. And presenting people with virtual environments that we can control and that we can use to show certain images of what may happen in the future, might certainly have an influence on people's behavior. So you could go this far. You could also stick to a bit more simple technology, like this energy light that we installed in people's homes that changes color from green to red, dependent on your energy consumption. And that is a form of feedback that is very simple and that you don't have to spend too much attention to. So it's something that's really easy to use. You don't have to think about it. It's and it's quite effective in influencing people's behavior. In one bit of a controversial study, we even used subliminal flashes of information, that is, presenting pictures very, very briefly for only 25 milliseconds. And more specifically, we presented people with a smiling or a frowning face while they were programming their programmable home thermostat. And when they pressed the down button, we would flash to them a frowning face. And when they pressed the up button, we would flash to them a smiling face. And using that intervention, we were able to influence people's energy consumption behavior in some tasks in which they had to program this thermostat for some situations at home. And of course, subliminally presenting information, has to be done for certain with the user agreeing to it. There's some ethical issues there, of course, unconsciously influencing people. But it might be quite effective, and it might also be something that people don't have to think about. Well, they can't. It all happens unconsciously. And still, they might be helped using such technology to diminish their energy consumption. So there's lots of other ways that you can use to influence people, and lots of strategies, and lots of strategies that are more effective than simply making people aware. Many people indeed are aware, but changing your behavior is another thing.
Definitely. So technology is all about that, by the way. And very last question to you, Jack, is what would you recommend to the consumer to do as an action in order to bring the energy consumption down?
Now, there's two domains of technology, of course, that might help us. Well, two domains of behavior, you could say. There's this domain of behavior where you can't really do much else than buy a certain new type of device, like, for example, a heat pump to heat your home in a more efficient way, or a smart little computer system that charges your car when the sun is shining. And it is important to invest in such material and in such products. And for these kind of decisions, you need to do some hard thinking and do some calculations, get help from other people. And then there's the domain of where you can change your behavior. A shower shorter, perhaps, lower the temperature a bit in your living room. And having the right motivation is a good starting point, but making the behavior easy for yourself, using a smart home thermostat, for example, that provides you with very, very simple and basic feedback, maybe something that can make this behavior much more easy for you. Now, there are these kind of thermostats on the market already. There's apps that can help you. So try to make it easy for yourself. Companies can help there too. That's going to help you change your behavior.
And by the way, this is what you can see on the different booths that we have.
Yeah.
Thermostat connected and all what we've been doing. So thanks a lot, Jeff.
Yep.
Question?
Are you saying because we are so scared of being judged, and then the influence, this kind of influence we can insert into AI system, and then we could be just more and then to change our behavior?
The question is, are we scared of being judged? And might that motivate us changing our behavior?
And then based on that fact, the fact that we are scared of being judged, and then we insert that kind of concept into AI system, that helps to change our behavior. Is that the concept?
I'm trying to look in a bit of a frowning way at you. I'm not very good at it. And you might experience not necessarily fear, but rather some kind of influence that goes on relatively automatically. And indeed, we know that people are very, very sensitive to other people's faces and the evaluation that is represented on that face. So it's not necessarily people are afraid of the evaluation by others, but they are very, very sensitive to it. And we already have such technology that uses these social influencing strategies. For example, websites that will tell you only today, or everybody buys this product. There's many different social influencing strategies that technology uses. And also there's smileys, all over the web and on many other pieces of technology also use those kind of influencing strategies. smart home technology may also use these influencing strategies, strategies that people are very sensitive to. So they may be very, very effective.
Yeah. And I would say it's not only also about fear, but it's also about sometimes you can have fear to be judged, but also you can look for comparison in order to be better and to improve, to be more efficient. And this is what we will see in another talk, for example, where Wiser is helping you that through the Wiser community. You have your results of energy consumption and you can see in similar homes what the others are doing and what they are performing. And then you can good tricks, you can good practices and implement them so you're becoming better and contributing to a more
sustainable world. Yeah, there's a very rich toolbox of influencing strategies that you can use. And social comparison is also a very effective one. Showing how well you're doing to your friends is something that many people are motivated by.
Thank you very much. I think it's closed the session. Thanks very much. It has been very, very interesting. A lot of insight. And I've learned a lot today. Hope you too. And see you for the next talk. Thank you very much, John.